What's up, Tim Sykes here with Kyle Williams. Where are we, Kyle?
We are in New Hampshire. Sunny, snowy New Hampshire.
It's so sunny out, okay? I'm just waking up. It's sunny out. It's freezing out. We're in this beautiful house. But right now, as of this moment, you're at like $750,000 in profits, which is crazy. And what'd you start with?
$6,000.
$6,000 to $750,000. No. What do you say to people say, like, this is impossible, you guys are faking it? Even though we show every trade and you're, like, literally working on your weekly review right now.
I couldn't disagree with them more. Like, just, if I made a vlog of my life and you saw me every day, what I do every day, you wouldn't think it's fake. Like, thousands and thousands of hours, you know, multiple hours a day, every single day.
I would argue that we're not even well paid for our time. Like, if you break it down per hour of, like, how much studying, like, you know, it's a Saturday morning. The first thing you do, you wake up and you start, like, reviewing your trades, right? Mm-hmm. Like, this is just what you do every Saturday morning?
Yeah, every Saturday I'll because during the week it's a little bit busier, especially in this market, how crazy it is. So I don't necessarily review my trades that same day. I usually like almost let them kind of sit for a few days. Yeah. And then so Saturday, I'll just review the whole week, how well I did, and then what I want to go do and change the next coming week.
And you had your biggest loss ever.
I did, yesterday,
Yep,
13,000.
Yep. How does that make you feel?
It was a very long-term swing trade, so I kind of was able to warm up to it. Yeah. It wasn't like a day trade where immediately I was down 13 grand. It was almost like I had a few weeks to realize, okay, this is, you know, if I stop at this price, it's going to be this. So I was able to prepare for it.
Mentally.
But when I took it, it was almost a relief. Like, I could finally let it go. You know, I was still green in the week. I'm still having the best month, you know, in this amazing hot market. So, and percentage-wise, it's not detrimental.
Yeah.
Right? I can easily come back from that. So that's how I kind of, I don't try to think about the number-wise. I think about how catastrophic it is to my account, to my overall trading, and you know I can keep moving
sometimes
along.
Sometimes you have to lose a battle to win the war.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. So funny enough, it's crazy how like there's like, you know, we have very similar journeys every now and then. Not all the time, but sometimes. Like last week, I took my biggest loss on a swing on REFR, which I was holding for 2 weeks. They make these cool vision dimming like windows, which I could actually use right now. I wish that this old 1840s farmhouse that we're staying in had like a little thing and I could just dim it. That's why my eyes are like half size. But I got kind of falling in love with the technology. You know, they're on the new Fisker, the upcoming Fisker electric vehicles. Their vision dimming windows don't just look cool. They also save range on electric vehicles. So you can save like 5%. So I was like, all it needs is one press release. And it broke. I bought it on a breakout, but it failed to hold the breakout. I didn't like cut small losses. And I just took the 5K loss. And that was my biggest loss of the year. But it's interesting, you know, to look at it from all angles. And I still finished up, you know, like nearly 20,000 on the week. So like it was, again, lose the battle, win the war. Right. I'm glad I was out. It was funny. I sold it after holding it for 2 weeks. Within an hour, the thing spiked up. I still don't know why it spiked up, but it would have been a $5,000 profit.
Yep.
An hour later.
That's frustrating.
But, you know, that's with swing trading, right? Like, swing trading is different. That's why I'm, not that great of a swing trader. I'm better at, like, morning panics or breakouts, like, a shorter time period. Mm-hmm. Are you better at shorter time periods?
Yeah. I think I would say only about 5% of my trades are swing trades, and they're usually always short swing trades.
Yeah.
Like, I'm very bad at swinging them long. Just mental capital uses, because I'm not one to like to set stops. So if I'm swing trading, I'm pretty much need to be watching it almost at least every hour, checking on it.
That's a lot of time.
It's a lot of energy and mental capital.
I mean,
for
you're shorting pumps. So with pumps, understand like you don't just short anything, especially in 2020. But if it's a blatant pump, like it's not a question of if, it's a question of when. You're also paying interest on this, like
over time.
To short it.
Yep.
So that's you know a few thousand dollars, right?
Yep.
So like, the interest plus the time plus the stock isn't breaking down, like why fight it, you know?
That's a lot.
And there's so many other plays like right now. Like I think right now, as we're filming this in December 2020, I don't know when we're gonna post this, but right now you have to really maximize your time because there's so many plays. It won't always be this hot of a market, but for the week, how much did you make for the week?
Like 25,000.
Yeah.
So I was up.
I love how he says it, like 25,000 for the week. This is not normal, okay? This is not normal. 2 years ago, what were you making in a week?
Oh, maybe 1-2,000. Yeah.
And a year before that, what were you making?
500, less than 500, a couple hundred a week.
Right? Yeah. If you picture this, if you had gone back in time, right? If somehow you can make 25,000 in a week in like 3 years ago, what would your reaction be?
Oh, I'd be I'd be insanely stoked.
Yeah. And now you're just like, no, yeah, I made some mistakes. I cut these losses. And the 25,000 is after your biggest loss.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I was up close to 40,000. Yeah. And then now it's down to
this 25. Is not normal. I actually leave a comment underneath this video. Understand that this market is not normal. 6K into 750K is not normal. Jack, you know, roughly 30K into 1.5 million. By the way, understand this. This is what's interesting. He had just crossed a million, like, what, in November?
October, November.
October, yeah. November. And now here we are in December and he's at 1.5. Like, this is not normal. Leave a comment underneath this, okay? And what I want people watching this to understand is that it's not just about the money that you make. Like, the money that you make right now or lose, I mean, it's based on, you know, patterns and preparation, right? Mm-hmm. So like you're putting in what you've used, what you've learned over the past 2-3 years, and you're putting it into practice in this crazy market. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I think about the past few years of the past few years on other markets where they were hot, right? We had usually a sector run every few months to years.
Weed, crypto,
right, all China. Yep. So all that preparation we had the last, you know, 2018, 2019,
yeah,
it just skyrocketed, you know?
So if you're just starting in 2020 and there's a lot of stocks moving, I get these messages. People are like, I don't know what to do. There's so many plays. And I'm like, it's okay. You got in, you know, during a crazy time. So not all years are created equal. So like, you know, you've been studying for three and a half years now? 4 years?
It's coming up on actually July 2021 will be 5 years.
Oh, 5 years. Yeah. Okay. So you've seen slow markets and you've seen, you know, fast markets. Mm-hmm. And the key is, and I hope, I pray on this whole tree, I pray on everything for a slow market, because that gives people watching this more time to prepare. Mm-hmm. They can learn better lessons. I think you learn the wrong lessons in a fast market where you're like, oh, look at all these plays. It's always going to be like this.
Yeah.
No, it's not. Again, for the third time, I'm going to say, leave a comment underneath saying this is not normal. If you understand, these are crazy days. Yeah. And this is, you know, me, you, Jack, you know, Crook, Roland, Good, Gratani, like all of us agree. Like, this is madness.
Madness, yeah.
You know? And are you enjoying it or are you a little overwhelmed?
I'm enjoying it and overwhelmed. Like, there's some days where I have too many tickers to watch. I literally can't trade or watch them all.
Yeah.
But then I think about it and it's like, this is the markets we kind of wish and hope for when it's slow.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm definitely learning to know.
You always want what you can't have.
Yeah, so right? I understand that this is the time to take advantage, because there's going to be, it's going to come. The slow months are going to come. So when it's fast, you should take advantage of while it's there.
Yeah. Are you working out or not as much?
No, I'm still working out. Yeah, yeah. That's I've learned, I first thought when I first started studying, the more I studied that the better I'd get, which is true to some extent. But if I started putting in so much time where I ignored other areas of my life, it actually hindered me. So I learned that no matter how bad I want to study or how bad I want to trade, putting a few hours aside for, you know, making sure I eat healthy or making sure I, you know, at least work out for like 30, 45 minutes is actually helps me in the long run.
I wish I could listen to your words of wisdom. I'm just trying to open my eyes in this sunlight. I hope this looks good on video, because it's killing my eyes. But I just want to be real with you. You know, again, I can't reinforce enough that most traders lose. Most traders are unprepared for hot markets like this. And we make videos like this just to kind of put everything in perspective. Like, it's pretty crazy. I mean, what motivated you to study so hard? Like, you saw other students doing well, and then you're like, oh, let me try to do this too.
Yeah, that, and I realized I loved the game of trading. When I finally figured out what that game was of, like, making money into more money and trying to really just play these stocks, I loved it. It was just a passion of mine from the beginning.
And that's a beautiful answer, because it's not just about the money that you make or lose in this game. You know, it's the challenge. Like, mm-hmm. it's fun to see, like, to go in and, like, use your own hard-earned money and, like, put in a thesis and be like, okay, mm-hmm. I think this stock is going to go up for whatever reason, whether it's the pattern, the news, the setup. Mm-hmm. But don't just get into this for money's sake. Get into this because you want to learn. You know, again, this is a crazy time. We got to go get dressed. Literally, Jack's girlfriend, she's in on this too. And she just had her best week ever. She just made 25,000 this week. Yeah. And she's, what, 20?
20 years old.
Which is crazy. We need more female traders. I just saw her car pulling up. She has the elf costume. So we have to get going. But again, leave a comment underneath this video saying this is not normal. Understand that this is a crazy market. Understand that you should be learning or earning. It's not just about making a lot. you know, if you're brand new, there's a lot of stocks moving. Don't feel bad if you miss it. Like FOMO, fear of missing out, is a real thing. Mm-hmm. I'm also going to include a link to my new holiday guide, specifically talking about all the plays right now and the tool that has really propelled me in 2020 to allow me to make over $1 million in trading profits. It's a crazy year. So stay safe above all else. I'm going to say it for like a fifth time. Like, most traders lose money. I cannot say that enough. So don't think that you're going to be, you know, my next millionaire student right away or make over $750,000. Hey, Mariana! Wait, come on camera for a second. I got to see you for a second. This is Jack's girlfriend. She is in on the surprise.
Hello.
Can you see her? All right, cool.
Let's go.
You have the costumes?
And all right. I have the keys.
Nice! We got to get going. Leave a comment underneath this saying, this is not normal. Study up.